Muhammad Azam Khan back in the screens. Today I am again here with another lecture, and this lecture is of bio. And in bio, the chapter number 4 cell identity flow, because we have done till chapter number 3. So now it's the turn of chapter number 4. Chapter number 4 is about cell biology and cell and tissue. Today we have a topic. So in this chapter is very lengthy, and so we will do it in many videos. So this in the first video, today our topic is about cell structure, okay? And there are functions also, but today we will do about cell structures. There are four structures, and we will do about the structures today, okay? We will do organelles in further lectures, okay? So first, what is cell, okay? Today first we will do that. What is cell? What is cell about? So cell is made of many of organelles and many of structures, okay? And there are structures and organelles working in it, and there is a nucleus in it. So for example, this is a cell with us, and there are many organelles and structures in it, okay? So first, cell history, okay? First we will do about cell history. But what is the history of the cell? So number first, it was been discovered by Robert Hooke in 1665. The first part is that was done by Robert Hooke in 1665. He observed the honeycomb. First he examined a tiny, he examined a slice of a cock, and what he noticed, okay, he noticed that it was a honeycomb in the cock. He first examined that by his self-made microscope. He have made by himself a microscope, light microscope, and he just examined the cock. So he observed a honeycomb with tiny compartments. There are tiny compartments you see in a comb, okay? If a honeycomb, there will be a tiny compartment if you observe it, okay? The compartments were like that, okay? There are like this type of compartments. The honeycomb is this type of compartment, and there are honey in it, okay? So he just named this as cellulae. He named it as cellulae, and this term cellulae has come with us as a cell. So this is the history of the cell, okay? Now we will do that structure and functions of the cell. There are structures, okay? There are structures in the cell. For example, the structures are four structures: cell wall, cell membrane, cytoplasm, and cytoskeleton. Today we will just read about these four structures, okay? So there, for example, if I take cell wall. So this is cell wall. This is cell wall, and cell wall only consists in plants, okay, not in animals, okay. It only consists in plants. The other is the cell membrane, and this cell membrane occurs in plants. Cell wall occurs in animals, and this cell membrane occurs in animals, okay. So cell, and then cytoplasm is like a gold like a balloon type thing, and there is water in it, okay? Water and fluid like in it, okay? We will study about cytoplasm. Next. Cytoplasm, and there is then cytoskeleton. Cytoskeleton is being defined by its name, that it is like a skeleton. It works like a skeleton in the cell, okay? It works like a skeleton in the cell, and it is like connected like the bones of the cell. It works like the bones of the cell, so it is like a skeleton. So this is cytoskeleton. This is cytoskeleton. So this was about cell, and there are much more organelles in it. Okay, there are many of organelles present inside it, such as mitochondria, nucleus, and many of it. We will study it further. Okay. So today, just our topic is about cell wall, cell membrane, cytoplasm, and cytoskeleton. These are structures, okay, and function will be functions will be the organ leaf. So cell, we will just today read about structure. So structure are four. First structure we will say cell wall. Cell wall is a non-living structure. What is the definition of cell wall? What is cell wall? Cell wall is a non-living structure that gives support, shape, protection and strength to the cell, okay? To the cell, not to the inner life of cell. It gives support, protection and shape to the inner living matter of the cell, okay? Like this cell wall is present only in plants, okay? This, remember that the cell wall will not be present in the animals, it will be only present in plants, okay? So cell wall work is that it gives support, protection and shape to the inner living matter of the cell. Now there are two types of cell walls, okay? One is primary cell. This primary wall, one is primary wall and the other is secondary wall. Secondary wall. In some plants, okay, not in all plants, there are just cell wall in plants and fungi and protists, okay? But this is not present always, okay? In some plants, the secondary and primary wall is present, okay? So this primary wall is made up of cellulose and other chemicals. And this secondary wall is made up of ये secondary wall जो है ये हमारे पास बना हुआ है हमारे पास किससे बना था ये हमारे पास lignin से बना था lignin से बना है सही है and other chemical. So this is about secondary and primary wall. ये तो हमारे पास plants में कभी ना कभी मौजूद होते हैं, तो हमारे पास plants में कभी ना कभी मौजूद होते हैं. फिर हमारे पास fungi और protists में भी हमारे पास ये cell walls मौजूद होते हैं. सिर्फ plants में नहीं, हमारे पास fungi और protists में भी मौजूद होते हैं. Plants में भी होते हैं, animals में नहीं होते हैं cell walls, okay? Animals में सिर्फ cell membrane होता है. सो हमारे पास ये प्लांट्स में कभी ना कभी मौजूद, कभी ना कभी हमेशा हमारे पास सेल वॉल ही होता है सिर्फ, लेकिन कभी ना कभी हमारे पास प्राइमरी सेल और सेकेंडरी वॉल होता है. फिर हमारे पास फंजाइस और प्रोटिस्ट में एंड प्रोटिस्ट में फंजाई और प्रोटिस्ट में हमारे पास कौन से सेल वॉल मौजूद है? फंजाई प्रोटिस्ट में भी हमारे पास सेल वॉल मौजूद होता है, लेकिन वो सेल वॉल हमारे पास काइटिन से बना होता है. वो सेल वॉल हमारे पास काइटिन से मेड अप ऑफ, सही, वो सेल वॉल हमारे पास काइटिन से बना होता है. सो हमारे पास, फिर से बताता हूँ कि सेल वॉल जो है, सेल वॉल का काम ये होता है कि ये प्रोटेक्शन देता है इनर लिविंग मैटर को. फिर हमारे पास प्लांट्स में कभी ना कभी दो टाइप के वॉल्स होते हैं, हमारे पास प्राइमरी वॉल फिर सेकेंडरी वॉल. प्राइमरी वॉल हमारे पास सेलुलोज से बना होता है और अदर केमिकल. सेकेंडरी वॉल भी हमारे पास लिग्निन से बना होता है और अदर केमिकल. फिर हमारे पास प्लांट्स में ही सिर्फ सेल वॉल नहीं मौजूद होता है, हमारे पास फंजाइज और प्रोटिस्ट में मौजूद होते हैं. फंजाइज प्रोटिस्ट में जो हमारे पास मौजूद है, वो हमारे पास सेल वॉल होता है, वो हमारे पास बना होता है काइटिन से, सही है. सो दिस वॉज पोर्स इन दिस सेकेंडरी एंड प्राइमरी वॉल्स, ओके. दे आर स्मॉल स्मॉल पोर्स इन साइड एंड दैट बाई दैट पोर्स दिस बोथ आर कनेक्टेड टू देयर साइटोप्लाज्म, ओके. फॉर एग्जाम्पल this is one cytoplasm, this is other cytoplasm, this is other and this is other. So there are small pores inside, okay. There are small pores inside it, okay. There are small pores inside it, and with these pores they are connected to their cytoplasm. Because of these pores they are connected to their cytoplasm, okay. Connected there. And they exchange their substances and the molecules to each other in by these pores. So this was about all the things about cell wall. Now the second structure, I forgot that these pores are known as plasmodesmata, okay. These pores are known as plasmodesmata. These pores are known as plasmodesmata. So this was all the things about. So now we will just move up to the second structure, and the second structure is cell membrane. Now the second structure with us is now what is cell membrane with us? Cell membrane works like a gate and a barrier. Okay, cell membrane works like a barrier, and that is connected. And cell membrane is a double mounted membrane. Okay, it is a double mounted membrane. It is a double bounded membrane, and it is connected to the double bounded membrane, and it is bounded by nuclear envelope. Okay, so this is cell membrane, and cell membrane works like a barrier. It's like a gate. Okay, and it is present in the on the surface of the cytoplasm of the cell. Like this is cell membrane with us. Okay, cell membrane with us. And its work is that it allows a few molecules, a few small molecules from outside inside the cell. Okay, it allows very small molecules from outside to in the cell. And there are, when there are bulky materials, bulky cells, it does not allow it to get in. Okay, so its work is that it just allows small molecules from outside to inside of the cell. So its work is now, if we just zoom out this type, just zoom out this diagram of the, if you zoom out this diagram of the cell membrane, it is like this. It is like this. Now what are these balls like? These are called lipids, and the diagram is like a bilayer. Okay, this diagram is basically known as bilayer, and this diagram name is Hewlett-Packard model. Okay, the microscopic picture of this cell membrane is known as this whole diagram is known as Hewlett-Packard model. This whole diagram is known as Hewlett-Packard model. Now this lipids are two, like a burger shape it is, so this is known as lipids bilayer. Okay, this both are known as lipid bilayer. Known as lipid bilayer. So it, so inside, this is the inside of the cell, and this is the outside of the cell. So this is known as, this thing is known as protein. This thing is known as protein. Okay, and this by this iske andar जो हमारे पास होता है, इसके अंदर अनदर थिंग होता है हमारे पास, उसे कहते हैं ग्लाइकोप्रोटीन. ओके, इस ग्लाइकोप्रोटीन की वजह से हमारे पास अंदर के नाम है, ग्लाइकोप्रोटीन से बने हुए हमारे पास के चैनल्स होते हैं. उन चैनल्स के जरिए हमारे पास इसके अंदर क्या नाम है, स्मॉल स्मॉल मटेरियल्स को इन करता है, और इधर से हमारे पास क्या नाम है, सेल का क्या नाम है, फूड एंड वाटर, ये इसके अंदर ट्रांसपोर्ट होता है. सो ये हमारा था सेल मेम्ब्रेन का टॉपिक आज का. अब हम सेल मेम्ब्रेन का टॉपिक तो हमारा हो गया कि दिस वॉज सेल मेम्ब्रेन, इट वर्क्स लाइक अ गेट एंड इट इज आल्सो डबल मेम्ब्रेन बाउंड स्ट्रक्चर. आई हैव मेड अ माइक्रोस्कोपिक पिक्चर टू यू आल्सो. सो दिस इज नोन एज सेल मेम्ब्रेन. ओके, आई होप इट विल बी क्लियर टू यू ऑल. नाउ वी विल मूव टू अनदर टॉपिक. अनदर टॉपिक विद अस इज साइटोप्लाज्म. The topic with us is now what is cytoplasm with us? Cytoplasm is also a structure with and it also plays a vital role in inside the cell of ours. Okay, so what work this cytoplasm does? Cytoplasm is like a gold type of container or like a balloon, and there is water in it. Okay, there is water and fluid in it. and inside this fuel there are much more chemicals like carbohydrates and lipids and proteins and other inorganic salts, okay, and other inorganic salts. These all the chemicals and carbohydrates, lipids, proteins and other inorganic salts are partially dissolved in this water, okay, are partially dissolved in this fluid which is in the cytoplasm. Now what is the work of this cytoplasm? Cytoplasm give a space, and cytoplasm help with other metabolic reactions. It just further carries the metabolic reaction. For example, a metabolic reaction, if I take glycolysis. So this is the metabolic reaction in which glucose are being broken down, okay. So this process is also being carried in cytoplasm. So this is the work of cytoplasm, that it gives a good and a complete space to the metabolic reactions. It carries the metabolic reaction which are done inside of the cell. So this is the work of cytoplasm. And for example, if I say glycolysis is a metabolic reaction of breaking down the glucose, and so breaking down of glucose is also a metabolic reaction. So this is done in cytoplasm. So this is the work of cytoplasm. So, अभी ये ग्लाइकोलाइसिस तो हमारे पास साइटोप्लाज्म करता है, लेकिन साइटोप्लाज्म खुद तो नहीं कर सकता. साइटोप्लाज्म के अंदर हमारे पास क्या नाम है, ऑर्गेनलीज होते हैं जो फ्रीली इनसाइड मूव कर रहे होते हैं हमारे पास ऑर्गेनलीज. फॉर एग्जांपल राइबोसोम्स ले रहे क्या नाम है, बहुत सारे माइटोकॉन्ड्रियस ले, तो वो सारे हमारे पास इसके अंदर क्या नाम है फ्रीली मूव करते हैं, और वही ऑर्गेनलीज हमारे पास इन मेटाबॉलिक रिएक्शन को होने को मदद करते हैं. सो ये था हमारे पास आज का साइटोप्लाज्म का टॉपिक. आई होप इट इज क्लियर टू ऑल. अब हम जाते हैं आगे साइटोस्केलेटन की टॉपिक की तरफ. सो हम आगे लेक्चर में करेंगे. आज के लेक्चर में हम हमारे पास अभी चौथा जो हमारे पास स्ट्रक्चर है वो हमारे पास है साइटोस्केलेटन. साइटोस्केलेटन, नाउ we will study about this cytoskeleton. This is the fourth structure with us, and these all four structures are not organelles, okay. So this cytoskeleton is a network of micro filaments and micro tubules. It is a network of microfilaments and microtubules. Now microfilaments and microtubules are the network by which cytoskeleton is done, okay. Cytoskeleton, it is being defined by its name that it works like a skeleton, okay. It works like a skeleton of the cell. So network of microfilaments and microtubules. Now what is microfilaments with us right here? Now what is microtubules with us? Microtubule is made up of tubulin protein. Filament is made up of a tubulin protein, and it work is that the microtubule work is in maintaining the cytoskeleton. The work of microtubule is that it help to hold the structure of the cell, okay. For example, this is the cell of fetus, and it works like a skeleton. So like this it works. It is a network like thing, and it helps to hold the structure. For example, our skeleton, if I did, it holds our body, it holds our structure. So like this microtubules are made up of tubulin protein, and it work is that it holds the shape of the cell, okay. Now we will come that what is microfilaments. Microfilaments are made up of actin protein, and their work is also it helps the cell to change its structure. This microfilaments are made up of actin protein, and then this microfilaments help the it work is that it helps the cell to change its structure. Okay, it helps the cell to change its structure. So this work of microtubules is this. So and these both important that these both are a product of cilia and then this microfilaments and microtubules, if you can see right here, this because of this microfilaments and microtubules, cilia and flagella are being made. Okay, so like this was our topic of cilia, cytoskeleton was the topic of cytoskeleton with us, and I have told you the structures of the cell, that there are four structures that are not organelles but they play a great role. ये अच्छा role play करते हैं हमारे पास क्या नाम है cell के अंदर cell की life को maintain करने के लिए. So ये हमारे पास structures and function नहीं किया, आज हमने structure किया है. तो हमारे पास structure of cell का हमने आप आज चार topics पढ़ लिए. So I hope this all the today's lecture will be clear to you all, और अपना ख्याल रखिएगा. गुड बाय फ्रॉम मोहम्मद अजान खान.